Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my brothers, my sisters. Ramadan is going well on one hand, and on the other hand, there are brothers and sisters of ours struggling across the globe for different reasons. Take a look at Palestine and what's happening there right now. Totally unacceptable, absurd. It bleeds, it causes the bleeding of the heart. And you know what? It hurts our souls. We want to see goodness and justice. We want to see a stop to the oppression and aggression. We would like to see protection of Masjid al-Aqsa, etc., etc. My brothers, my sisters, that is the duty, not just of the Muslims, but of every human being, to want peace, goodness, justice, stability, a stop to aggression, oppression, and protection of the holy lands. May Allah Almighty grant that to us. My brothers, my sisters, usually in Ramadan, I travel to a different part of the world or different parts of the world. Taraweeh, Salat al-Taraweeh, we participate in, and a lot of lectures we do. This time, it was a little bit different where I decided, you know what, after many, many years, I need to, in Ramadan, visit the holy lands, perhaps to help ourselves enrich, get closer to Allah, spiritual enrichment, and become better people, and concentrate on personal ibadah and acts of worship. But in the same breath, I thought to myself, wherever we get an opportunity of da'wah, we will seize it. And so, subhanAllah, I was invited to Dubai. And I started off Ramadan in Medina. I dashed over to Mecca, made Umrah, came back, and then I went to Dubai for 3 days. The first day we had a massive event at the Al Manar Islamic Center. It was a beautiful event attended by thousands of people. We had a shahada. And we have regular shahadas. Through this month of Ramadan, I don't even know how many shahadas we've had, alhamdulillah, be they online or offline, or in public or in private. But my brothers and sisters, the next day we had another program also in Dubai, which was absolutely amazing at the Sheikh Hamdan bin Rashid Masjid. And it was beautiful. Thousands of you attended, and the talks are posted online, mashallah, tabarakallah. The following day also we had the third event, public event. It was amazing in the same masjid, Masjid al-Sheikh Hamdan bin Rashid. And this event was also beamed. I had recorded it on my phone. You know, whenever you see these videos on my YouTube channel, a lot of them are recorded just with my own phone. Right now I'm speaking from the same phone, subhanAllah. So my brothers and sisters, something happened that was very different from how it was portrayed later on. And I want to talk about this a little bit because I know from amongst you, there are people who are genuine. That's the majority. And then there are mischief makers trying to push agendas. We need to be careful of them. Then there are journalists. Each one of them has a different level of fear of Allah if they're Muslim. And each one of them could be belonging to a little group or sometimes heavily politicized to a certain country or to a certain cause. And so they look at everyone else as enemies. They seize the opportunity of something to just say a word that would put down everyone who doesn't support their own cause. So let me explain to you what happened. The third day, just as, and I left later on after the event on that day, and the masjid event, I left and I actually left the UAE because I had to continue in my journeys. Right now, if you want to know where I am, I'm speaking to you, I am in Doha, in the capital of Qatar. And this evening we have a massive event in Qatara, the amphitheater. And inshallah, I pray it will be a huge success by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to speak all about Ramadan. Literally, that's the topic I was given, all about Ramadan. And inshallah, we want to showcase it to the people and talk about it and what we're going to benefit from it and so on and so forth and what it does to us, inshallah. But the evening before I left Dubai, I was invited by the hosts, the Islamic Affairs, to say, today we'll be having iftar, inshallah. I had iftar anyway to the previous few days. And that particular day, we had iftar at a certain place where they had invited people from all walks of life. Most of them were Muslim, probably 1,000+ people from what my eyes saw. And thereafter, I met a lot of Muslims, a lot of Christians, a lot of Hindus, a lot of Sikhs, and many others. And we sat for iftar. I had my iftar, I broke my fast, I made my Salatul Maghrib, greeted a few people and went away. Those who know me know I don't like to sit for too long somewhere. I like to just, you know, sit, do whatever I have to and leave. Because we were there for an iftar, I had that iftar. Just before iftar, a Jewish man walked, sat next to me. I asked him who he was and where he was from. He was from New York, lived in Dubai for quite a few years. He said about 8 years, I think. And mashallah, there was a very light discussion. I had no presentation there. I had no major participation there. I was just a guest who came in and had iftar, made Salatul Maghrib and went. The idea of that iftar was in order to showcase the Ramadan to the non-Muslims who are resident of the UAE. That's not a bad idea. And it happens in London, it happens in Canada, it happens in US, it happens in Muslim countries, it happens in so many communities, it happens so much across the globe where, the iftar and the Ramadan and Islam and so on and the teachings and the way it happens and what it's supposed to do for us and the ambience of it is all showcased to people who don't know much about Islam. So later on when I left, I saw a few news articles that were quite accurate initially. There was this iftar arranged by so-and-so for people of all faiths to get together who are living in the UAE. And the idea is the harmony and the understanding and so on and so forth, which is true. Later on, I noticed, and I'm going to say a name, I'm in Doha right now and I'm in Qatar. And imagine that would prove to you that I've got nothing to do with the politics of everything. We're above it, subhanAllah. But truth be said, Al Jazeera Arabic wrote a very mischievous title. They gave it a very deceiving title that was serving an agenda of hate, nothing else. And when I saw it, I said, this is a lie. They had a picture. The picture they chose, and I don't even know if they were talking about that particular event, because there may have been other events elsewhere, I don't know, but most probably. The picture they chose was one where I was seated with a Jewish man on this side and one of the organizers on the other and so on. And you know what? There were people of other faiths on the same table. And what had happened? So they wrote, oh, this was an iftar celebrating normalization of whatever, whatever. And they wrote whatever served their agenda, which I felt was very, very wrong. You know, I didn't think so badly of Al Jazeera or others until I saw this article and I said to myself, the person here doesn't know the damage that they're doing. Intentionally, they have misconstrued, misinterpreted, written a headline that's going to get across the globe that is so false. It is absolute rubbish. That's what they wrote. Total nonsense. And they added in the article things of whatever politics might have happened in the past or is happening, which had nothing to do with the particular event. Absolutely nothing. So, what do you do now? I guess it happens to people, to politicians, to religious people who are popular, to people who are known across the globe and so on. They seize this opportunity to say things. My name wasn't written at all because I was not one of the organizers. I didn't know anything. My name wasn't written at all in that article. But obviously people would recognize me because I'm a known person. Later on, our Muslim brothers from Islamic, journalistic channels that document whatever, or they speak about the pillars of Islam, or they speak about what's going on in the Muslim Ummah, which is a good thing in essence, but they decided to carry the false tale, and they decided to portray it as though Mufti Menk is compromising his faith and this. Wallahi, that didn't happen. I just want to clarify. We stand with our brothers and sisters in Palestine and with Masjid al-Aqsa forever, forever. We stand with them. We believe in the cause and we believe in it forever. SubhanAllah. And for your information, the last time I tried to go there, they denied me entry. They actually told me, sorry, you can't come. And there we go. So SubhanAllah, we still stand for the cause. And here are people saying, oh, we did this and we did that. And SubhanAllah, no, no, no. For me, it was a simple iftar. We went in, I met a lot of people. Later on that night, we even had a shahada. And SubhanAllah, we're busy thinking any shahada you can get is a gain. SubhanAllah. Here we are showcasing the deen. You know, the people of other faiths are not your enemies. They are the ones through whom you will get the shahadas. They are the ones through whom you will get Jannah if you happen to work or you happen to showcase them the deen and understand. Another thing is when you have an enemy who is no longer an enemy, for example, because of, you know, someone who hated Islam. I remember there was an old lady who said, "I hated Islam, but because of the good teachings that I've now seen come from yourselves as Muslims, I no longer hate it, but I'm still not a Muslim." Well, that's a gain, isn't it? So subhanAllah, you need to understand this. My brothers, my sisters, the field of da'wah is vast. I would never have spoken about this, but I believe there are genuine people out there who will understand what we've said. So my brothers and sisters, you know something? If we have had an opportunity to showcase Islam and the iftar to a group of non-Muslims, alhamdulillah, it's not bad. For as long as you didn't compromise your Salatul Maghrib, you didn't compromise your, you know, your faith and so on, alhamdulillah. And mashallah, you know, we, according to me, I had that opportunity. And like I said, there was even a shahada later on. But some days later, I saw these terrible articles, absolute rubbish. If you ask me, I don't even like to use that word, but it was totally unacceptable. Totally taken out of context. They just got a picture of the moment when I was there. And subhanAllah, they just gave it a story that didn't even fit what happened on the ground. I hope that this clarification or this sort of, narration of what actually happened is understood by the people who fear God Almighty. As for the journalists, I've given up a long time ago on most of them, because even the last time we had Muslims, people I know, who looked for the worst possible thing to say about a photograph, and they said it in order to gain popularity, in order to serve their cause, in order to bash a popular person, in order to find fault in what someone else is doing. That's all. When you see a photo and you think the worst as a journalist, I can name some of these guys. They know who they are actually. Dirty, dirty minds, dirty hearts and souls. Why? Come on, clean it. Clean it, please. You have an Allah. You have not an Allah. You have Allah to go back to. Subhanallah. You have a Lord. That's what I mean. You have a Lord to go back to. To answer. Don't you fear the day you're going to die, going to your grave? Subhanallah. If what's happening politically is happening politically, it's got nothing to do with me. Subhanallah. It can keep on happening, whatever it is. We are totally separated from that. We are, you know, people who promote the deen. Any opportunity of da'wah, we are there. Subhanallah. So may Allah Almighty grant us goodness and protect us in every single way. And may Allah Almighty grant us the harmony, the peace, the stability we need in our own minds and in our souls to begin with. But please fear Allah regarding what you say. If you see a photograph and think of the worst possible thing, you need help. You need help. And if you've written it and spread it, you've actually created a bigger problem in the ummah than what exists right now. So if we have a big disaster in a few places in the world, and we do, by you creating this type of hate, you're creating hate in the Muslim ummah, so much hate in the hearts for one another, and you were the one who caused it. May Allah forgive you guys, honestly. And may Allah forgive all of us. May Allah forgive me as well for any of my shortcomings, knowingly or unknowingly. And may Allah grant us true love as an ummah. May Allah help us to stand up for the good causes, the causes of justice and goodness. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevate the status of all of us. أقول قولي هذا. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.